Brincadeira.
Já, Michael?
Michael.
מייקל דוראן הוא על הקו, אבל לא מצליח לשמור.
היי, תוכל לנסות עם מייקל לשאול אותו, לדבר איתו, להדריך אותו תוך כדי? מייקל דוראן. מה? אוקיי. בסדר, בסדר. תהיה מולו ונראה מה קורה. מסתדר עם דורי או לא? דניאל? אוקיי, let's start. We are trying to talk to the Michael to see if he's okay. Let's start. No problem.
All right. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. We want to discuss what's going on in Iran. Definitely, Iran is the country in the Middle East that was most stricken by the coronavirus crisis. But it comes at a time when so many other things are happening in Iran, so it's some sort of a perfect storm that the Iranian regime has to face. As one of our speakers, Javad Khadem, told me a minute ago, this is something that is so much in the ordinary for the Iranians. They are always in crisis. But still, I think this crisis is a little bit different than previous ones. And we are talking already about so many people that lost their lives over there, more than 2,200. And it's coming in under the American sanctions and so on and so forth. It's really something unique and unprecedented vulnerability of the Iranian regime at this point. We have four speakers for this session. First we'll go Colonel in the reserve, Miki Segal, who used to take care of Iran in the Israeli military intelligence ages ago, but still keeps an eye on Iran for the Jerusalem Center for Public Affairs. And then we shall have Javad Khadem. Javad Khadem, who is the former minister in the Iranian government, the housing minister under Shapur Bakhtiar. And after him, we shall have Dr. Michael Duran from the Hudson, senior fellow at the Hudson Institute in Washington, to present also the American attitude to that, an American view of that situation. And I will bring the General in reserve, Yossi Kavas, the last speaker, and I'll try to put everything together and see where are we going from here. Now, if you have any questions while the speakers speak, there is a chat option, so please add your questions on the chat option, so we shall be able to refer to them after each of the speakers make his initial presentation. Thank you very much, and I'll ask Miki Segal to be the first speaker.
Okay, good morning, everybody, good afternoon. As Cooper said, Iran, this coronavirus epidemic caught Iran in some kind of a crossroad in its history. While the election to the Madrid took place, a celebration of the revolution, after the targeting of Qasem Soleimani, after the riots. So I think the corona came in a very very problematic time for the Iran regime. At the first stages of this crisis, the Iran regime, in the previous cases, tried to hide or to ignore all the problem. Took the regime a few weeks to start a real reaction. As we can see, the Iran regime today is banning people from traveling across Iran. Of course, we have the Nowruz a few days ago, and we saw a lot of Iranian, despite the regime, ban to ban people from traveling. They traveled from city to city. Even they went to Qom. People from Qom visited the many places in Iran and actually did not help the regime to cope with managing this this crisis. I think another point, when we have almost 3,000 people infected with the coronavirus and over 2,200 people killed, those are the official numbers, but the actual numbers are according to the health organization, is much higher, about between 6,000 to 10,000 people already dead in this coronavirus. And I think some people maintain that this coronavirus is out of control in Iran, while in Iran there is an ongoing fight, inner fight between the leader and the IRGC on one hand and Rouhani and his government on the other hand. So I think this is a good opportunity for us to see and to look into the dynamics between Iranian leadership, between the leader and the IRGC and Rouhani government. And in the middle, of course, there is the American sanction with the apparently President Trump is not willing to give up the crippling sanction on Iran. Against this background, we can see in recent day there was a cartoon contest in Iran to show how bad Trump is after they called the sanctions economic terrorism. Now they call the conduct of the United States administration in the corona crisis, they call it health terrorism. And in fact, in the last few days, we can see some kind of, we could term it, let's say, corona diplomacy on behalf of the Iranian regime, with Iran trying to press the United Nations Security Council, other nations in the world, to try and persuade the United States to ease the sanction. But on the other hand, we can see the leader of Iran in his speech, two speeches on the eve of Nowruz, he actually blamed the United States for further spreading the disease and even adjusting the coronavirus to the Iranian genetic, let's say, charge or something like this. And really, we can see the gap between the United States and Iran is growing very deep in recent days, with this mistrust between the two sides is going, I don't know how to call it, but the level of mistrust between the United States and Iran is deepening. And indeed, I think if really between Khamenei's lines in his speeches, we can see that last year, he termed last year the year of construction, of production, to this year was termed leap in production. And I think actually what is happening, that that Khamenei is preparing the Iranian people for a more resistive economy this year, with oil prices are down almost $25-$20 per barrel, and the Iranian budget is suffering a lot. I don't know, I think they prepared the budget on about $70-$80 per barrel, but now the crisis is deepening because of the lack of income from oil. Another thing is I think the last year was a very, very tough year for Iran. They weren't able to recover from one crisis, and they found themselves in another crisis. And now they are in a very very severe crisis that really tests the Iranian regime to its utmost. And I think if we take all the things that happened, the bad things for the Iranian regime, I'm not saying about the natural disasters, but also what you could say man-made or Trump-made disasters for the Iranian regime, the level of mistrust of the level of mistrust on behalf of the people. I think the coming year it will be a very important, I think, to some kind of a crossroad for the Iranian regime, because whilst the pandemic is still spiraling in Iran, I think once Iran and the other, the national, the global will get over the, this disease, I think we'll see some kind of a dramatic change in the Iranian regime. And the people, once they can, they will be able to go to the streets, and they will go back to the street. They will storm the street, and I think we'll see in the coming Iranian year a change in the regime, and the people will not suffer anymore all the atrocities of the regime. And I think the coronavirus, I think, will be the last day. Thing that will eventually will topple the regime, or will have will create the base for a regime change in Iran. Still, we are in the very early stages of this pandemic. It's not still its highest in Iran, but I think will worsen in Iran, and I think it will take effect in the medium to the long term. Can see a dramatic change in the Iranian regime and Iranian conduct.
Thank you, Mickey. Okay.